Another starter's orders for the St. Lucia Stakes and Trophy, and we have a couple of horses given trouble in the gates, but I think they're settled now. In gate one, we have failed Prime Minister Kenny Anthony. The odds don't look too good for him. I think we may be witnessing his final race before he is put down. Next to him in gate two, UWP defector Stevenson King. He has switched jockeys and will now be wearing the blue out of the Judas stables. We expect to soon see him in red. Then in gate three, it's Richard Frederick. As we know, he can only ride in the local derby because he has no visa. And in gate four, we have Philip J. Pierre. He has an injury and we are not too sure if he can finish this race. We don't even know why he's in it, actually. Anyway, and they're off. Heading straight to the front is Kenny Anthony. He likes running solo, but oh no, he is fading already. It's clear he doesn't have much else to offer. Coming up on his outside now is Stevenson King. We were all wondering when he would finally make his move, but look at this. Closing in on his rear quickly is Frederick. He's actually right up on him, whispering something in his ears. This is going to be an interesting one. And way in the back, we see Philip J. Pierre limping along. He's already out of the contest, just as we called it. But back to the front of the pack, and the top two are neck and neck, thick as thieves, King and Frederick. Frederick and King, we can't tell the difference between them. St. Lucia, this is going right down to the wire. It will be a photo finish, and Frederick steals it at the line. Wow! King looks very dejected behind after investing so much to become Prime Minister again. But this race doesn't matter because it's for second place as the UWP continues to lead and do a fantastic job.
Vote UWP and let's keep working.
Let's keep working.